Good afternoon to everyone. This afternoon, I'm happy to share with you the significant findings of our project entitled Utilization of Biomass Furnace Byproduct for Industrial Application. And also, I would like to thank Circa for everything. So before I go to my presentation, first I would like to introduce my office. So PILMEC, formerly called the National Post Harvest Institute for Research and Extension, or NAPAL, created on May 24, 1978 through Presidential Decree 1380 and was made a subsidiary of the National Food Authority in 1980. Became an attached agency of the Department of Agriculture in 1986 and transformed into a regular agency through EO-494 and renamed as the Bureau of Post-Harvest Research and Extension, and became the PILMEC, or the Philippine Center for Post-Harvest Development and Mechanization. So, situated at the science city of Muñoz de Ecija, it is 147 kilometers north of Manila. So, Science City of Muñoz is the center of agricultural research and technology in Central Luzon. Consists of 18 various research and development centers. And we are mandated to generate, extend, and commercialize appropriate and problem-oriented agriculture and fishery post-harvest mechanization technologies. Our vision is the premier center for post-harvest mechanization development for a globally competitive and sustainable agriculture and fisheries sector. So our mission is to empower the agriculture and fisheries sector by increasing resource use efficiency and productivity, reducing losses, and adding value to the produce through research, development, and extension. Okay, so sa ting, I hope na enough na po yung introduction ng aming office. Going back to my presentation, so one of the important concerns that the Philippines and other developing countries is facing nowadays is the capability to have an affordable, dependable, and renewable energy source. Historically, the Philippines has been heavily dependent on imported oil for its energy needs. So with the rising cost of fossil fuel energy, coupled with the increasing population of the country, the pressure of harvesting alternative fuel option grow bigger every day. The Philippines, being an agricultural country, has 43.3% total land area devoted to agricultural crops. So a large volume of agricultural residues and byproducts are generated annually. But they are poorly utilized and badly managed since most of these waste are left to decompose or they are burned, resulting in energy, environmental pollution and degradation. At PILMEC, so biomass furnaces were developed and retrofitted to mechanical dryers as source of heat. So the main objective of this project was to reduce the drying cost using mechanical dryers and to increase utilization of this type of dryers. Considering this potential and economic benefits, the Department of Agriculture, through fields, fertilizer, irrigation, infrastructure, extension and education, loan, and insurance, dryer, and other post-harvest facilities and seeds program lead to intensify the utilization of biomass furnace for mechanical dryers. However, the byproduct derived during the utilization of the biomass furnaces, such as carbonized rice hull, carbonized corn cobs, is now becoming a secondary waste problem due to its continuous accumulation within the drying area, which also creates pollution in the locality. So one viable solution to this problem is to mine this carbonized material by converting them into densified form or briquettes. So briquetting is the process of converting low bulk density biomass into high density and energy concentrated fuel. Charcoal briquettes are good alternative sources of fuel. It can easily be ignited to produce heat or convert heat into fuel for domestic and industrial application. So the general objective of this study is to determine the potential of carbonized materials derived from biomass furnaces as fuel briquettes. So specifically, characterize the chemical properties of carbonized biomass-based fuel briquettes, determine the effect of sources of biomass by product and by the proportion on the physical and thermal properties, establish the optimum physical properties of the fuel briquettes, and determine the production cost of producing this product. So on the methodology, the carbonized material were collected from Filmec developed furnaces. So we have four different types of furnaces. So this one is a multi-fuel biomass furnace. So we can it can be used either rice hull or corn tubs. So this is an indirect type furnace. And the next is the direct fire rice hull furnace with heating over. Another type of furnace is the direct fired rice hull furnace with step rate, and then the biomass fed rice hull furnace heater system. So a representative sample of carbonized material collected from Filmec developed furnaces and existing carbonizer were collected for proximity and chemical analysis. So characterization of material was analyzed through the FPRDI. And the parameters determined include moisture content, volatile combustible matter, fixed carbon, and ash content. So production of briquette was conducted using two types of briquetting machine. So this one is the piston type briquetting machine. So the biomass was punched into a die by a reciprocating ram with a very high pressure, thereby compressing the mass to obtain a compacted product. So according to the owner of this equipment, it was designed by the Department of Science and Technology, FPRDI. So ito na po yung aming, kasi yung equipment na ginagamit po namin is naka-base sa Bicol. So, eh kami is sa Muñoz. So, napigitan kami gumawa, but we include yung ano na po siya, engine-driven OTC operation. So, the same piston type. And then another is the extruder type. So ito po is naka-base din sa Bicol. So extruder type, use a low shear, high compression, and group bar and strip to enhance mixing. So the rotating screw takes the material from the feed port through the barrel and compact it against the taper die. So the densified material was forced to intimate and substantially slide in contact with the barrel port. Also, we use hammer mill to reduce the size of the carbonized material, in particular with corn cobs. So, napakalaking effect po kasi ng particle size sa production ng ating mga fuel briquettes. So, we also use a mechanical mixer to ensure the homogeneous mixing of binder and carbonized material. So the physical properties such as density, shatter resistance, abrasive resistance, resistance and compression strength were evaluated and analyzed. So this is the standard test para po masabi natin na yung ating briquette is maganda in terms of physical. Another is the thermal properties. So calorific value. So the calorific value of the produced briquette was determined using, so ito po yung standard method of test. So it was also conducted at FPRBI. So on the experimental design, so the data gathered were analyzed using factorial in CRD, and then ANOVA was utilized to determine the level of significance among treatments. On the results, so this figure shows the chemical properties of carbonized material obtained from PILMEC developed biomass furnaces. So the carbonized rice hull derived from biomass fed rice and furnace heater system or F4 has significantly high combustible volatile matter. So compared to other CRH byproduct. While the significantly high amount of fixed carbon content is evident dun sa corn cobs. So yung sa corn cobs, kung ang requirement po kasi ng mga dryer is mataas na temperature, so we need to increase the feeding rate. So ang nangyayari is hindi na po fully burn yung corn cobs sa, kasi mas malaki po yung size ng corn cobs compared doon sa rice hull. So nakakaroon ng incomplete combustion. So this slide show the different carbonized material based fuel briquette. So the briquette is a cylindrical in shape with hole in the center to promote the efficient combustion. So the size is 50 mm in length with an outside and inside diameter of 50 mm and 60 mm. So, una po is good. So this is purely carbonized rice hull, then carbonized corn cob. So we also tried carbonized rice hull for us, plus other biomass such as coconut shell, sodas, rice hull, corn cob, and then paper. So this table shows the density of fuel briquettes derived from carbonized rice hull. So the average density of carbonized rice hull was 0.48 and 0.65. So, mas mataas po doon sa screw type na printing machine. So, this could be due to the amount of pressure applied. So, sa corn cobs, average is 0.53 to 0.64. So, same. Yung school type is mas mataas po yung density. So the average percent impact resistance using piston type and screw type was 86.15 and 75.37. So the highest percent impact resistance was obtained in fuel briquettes using piston type. So this can be associated to the high amount of binding agent required in the formulation of briquettes. So the binding agent in sub-piston type is from 7.5% to 12.5%, while the size screw is 1.75 to 2.25. So pag ginamit niyo po itong binding agent o percent binding agent dito sa type ng printing machine, nakakaroon na po na dito is nagiging weak. Pag ito naman nilagay natin dito, is nagkakaroon naman ng clogging doon sa equipment. So, different type of briquetting machine requires different binding, percent binding dito. So, ganun din po sa corn crops. So, the percent impact resistance is significantly different on carbonized material from different furnaces. So, on the table 5, the percent abrasive resistance of carbonized rice hull fiber briquettes was obtained in, or the highest percent abrasive resistance was obtained in piston type briquetting machine. On the average is 97.75. So the high amount of binding agent in the formulation increased the abrasive resistance of the produced briquettes. So sa corn cobs, ganyan din po. So hindi kasi namin pwedeng i-compare yung rice hull saka sa corn cobs. So kaya nagkakaroon po siya ng separate na table. But still, yung kanilang result is parehas na. On the compressive strength, so table 7 show the compressive strength of carbonized rice hull dual briquette. So the compressive strength was a criterion of briquette durability. So the compressive strength increased with increase in binding agent ratio applied. And also, several researchers reported that it was difficult to obtain repeatability of the result on the compressive resistance for the same quality. And also, there are no standard criteria on the acceptance level for strength of densified products. So, same with support. Okay. So, this figure shows the heating value of human briquette using corn cobs and carbonized rice hull based fuel briquettes. So, the heating value of carbonized corn cob reaches as high as 5,037. So, carbonized rice hull plus corn coconut shell, 6,420. Carbonized rice hull plus sodas, 5,495. CRH plus rice hull, 4,831. And then corn cobs, 5,915. CRH plus paper is 5,467. And the standard or the minimum heating value para ma-sustain yung ating o hindi siya maka-maintain siya lang sa cooking only 4,793 calories per kilogram. So lahat naman po siya is above, so it could sustain heating. So we also did a partial budget analysis on the utilizing biomass fed furnace by product as fuel feed. So if the farmers or if the biomass fed furnace owner, kasi po nagpamigay kami ng around more than 1,000 dryers nationwide. Kaya ito po yung, if the biomass fed furnace owner shall acquire the machine for the production of fuel briquettes, the owner will earn an additional income of 3.5 pesos per kilogram. Ngayon, kung mag-rent lang po siya ng equipment, so magkakaroon siya ng additional na 1.5 peso per kilogram. So we also did simple financial analysis. So the estimated investment cost is around 132,000, and then the investment cost include yung briquetting machine, mixer, and then yung hammer mill. So from the assumption that the investor shall acquire the machine for costume services, financial analysis showed that the project is profitable with a benefit cost ratio of 2.2 and an IRR of 1.96, and the payback period 25.16, and the payback period is, or the investment cost can be recovered in 1.96 years. Okay, for the conclusion, so the carbonized materials derived from Pilmec biomass furnaces can be utilized to produce high quality briquettes with high durability rating and heating value. The energy values and combustion qualities of the produced briquettes in this study are sufficient enough to produce the required heat for domestic cooking and also for industrial application. Okay, the Pilmec biomass bed owner will earn an additional income of 1.5 and 3.5 for the in processing of the carbonized material as fuel. Okay, so we recommend that a briquetting system be integrated in the rice grain processing center owned a biomass furnace in the mechanical drying operation. So this is to add value to the biomass byproducts obtained from the furnace. Okay, that's all. Thank you and God bless.
Questions from the floor? Okay, Dr. Mars.
I'm gonna hop on. I'm just curious, what kind of stove did you use? Did you also come up with a design specific for the briquettes?
Actually, meron po mga commercially available na mga stove. Pero yun nga, nag-design din kami actually ng stove. So it can accommodate 6 pieces na pwede na siyang mag-cook ng yung pang 1 kilo of rice. But there are existing mga design ng mga stove. And yun po, naka-design naman din siya sa mga. Pero sa ngayon po kasi ang iba kasi 1 piece of fuel briquettes sa isang stove, naka-design siya. Pero dito, gumamit kami ng existing and then dinilang po namin kung ano ang kung ilan lang yung kaya niya i-accommodate. So, kaya niya i-accommodate is mga 6 pieces. Approximately mga 1/2 kilo of charcoal. Yes, ma'am. Ano po? Mga 55mm by 55mm. Cylindrical machine.
Yes, Dr. My former boss.
Hi, good afternoon. Very interesting presentation. I'd just like to ask, what's the purpose of the briquettes? Is it for domestic or industrial heating?
Both, sir.
Okay, yes. I would disagree with your conclusion,
yes,
that it is suitable for industrial heating. From the result of your experiment, if you could pull up the graph, okay, the calorific value is quite low, like maybe 6,000 calories, so that's pretty low for industrial application. Probably maybe 19 megajoules would be sufficient, but 5,000 probably that's just suitable for residential stove heating. No? Mm. Definitely, the heat value of the carbonized material is not sufficient for boilers or furnaces. Okay? If you look at the result, most of the material has very high ash content. Okay, did you analyze this for like trace elements or heavy metals? Because usually this ash has like a lot of potassium and sodium that could result in deposits if you're going to use this for boiler fuel. And only one material, is that corn cob?
Corn cobs, yes.
Corn cob has a relatively higher fixed carbon, which could indicate it has possibility as a fuel, but the rest are poor fuel, if you ask my opinion.
Yes.
And I have one more. What was the binder used?
Starch, cassava starch.
Cassava starch, okay. I would suggest that you do elemental analysis so that you would have a better idea if the carbonized material is suitable. But definitely, mataas pati yung standard error ng results.
Actually, sir, sir, iba-ibang parties dito, sir. Iba-ibang parties. So, iba-ibang parties, iba-iba yung characteristic ng kanilang mga ash.
No, no. This is for...
Yes, sir.
So, proximity analysis, right?
Yes, sir.
Standard error, it's like half the value. So, it's like a large variability in measurement. Okay, so, probably you should explain that if you're going to write a report of
yes.
The result. Anyway, yes, it's interesting. It provided us alternative for the use of furnace and product. But probably, a new way of augmentation to the raw material itself, because as it is, I don't think it would be suitable for industrial fuel, but probably for residential heating, I still think it would be suitable anyway. But that's potential for residential heating.
Nice.
Thank you.
Sir, ito po sa observation. Actually, yung nga sir, yung kung yun po, yung sa ating furnaces, especially yung gumagamit ng mga rice pan, so napakababa ng kanilang mga available combustible matter. Unlike so sa corn cups, mataas talaga siya kasi yun nga, in terms of size, so hindi talaga nagpupulibor yung ating biomass. Kaya ang ginawa po namin doon sa mga CRH, so nagkaroon kami ng CRH based fuel briquettes. So meron kami mga substrates na nilagat na dinagdag katulad ng kung halimbawa ang owner ng furnace is naka-base sa Aurora, so pwede siyang mag-add ng coconut shell. And yun nga, tama sa yung observation niyo, mababa na ang heat ng available dun sa CRH. But ang isa pong naging purpose kaya namin inilagay pa din ang CRH is para maging ano na din siya as filler. Kasi napakahirap i-densify yung coconut shell kung hindi siya may grain mabuti. Unlike yung kung meron siyang filler na CRH, mas tumataas yung kanyang density. Same with doon sa rice hull. Kung raw na rice hull, napakahirap yung i-densify yan kasi napaka-porous. Kung i-grind mo siya into napakamaliit na particle, so ang magiging implication is tataas yung ating production cost kasi we need an additional energy for the, reducing the size of the material. So, yun po, parang na-supplement niya yung low heating value ng CRH kasi nag-serve siya ng as feeder ng briquette. So, mas madali pong i-densify. But still, ano po, mataas pa rin naman yung, kumbaga, mas mataas po yung nilagay natin percentage ng mga substrates. So, halimbawa yung furnace owner is nakabase sa Isabela, so marami pong abundant supply ng corn cups, so pwede niya sigil-tingan. Pero kung corn cups, so pwede siyang stand-alone. And then, yun nga po, for the information of everybody, we have also developed a mechanical dryer which requires a low heating. So nag-aabits lang po ito ng mga 40 to 45 degrees Celsius. So hindi mo kailangan ng mataas na heating value to accommodate yung drying operation ng mga product. Like yung saan po sa, meron kami dinevelop na in collaboration with the German company, yung Multi commodity solar panel dryer. So, ito po is ang heat na ginagamit naman is solar. But the problem is during night time, wala namang solar, so kailangan namin ng supplemental heating para hindi masira yung product na dinadry. So, ito po yung pwede namin, ito yung nire-recommend namin na pwede namin gawin. Yes, pero yung sir, tama po yung mga observation. And yes sir, okay po yung mga
ang itatanong ko po ay tungkol naman sa paggamit o utilization at saka yung marketing. ako paminsan-minsan pumupunta sa palengke, pero hindi ako nakakita niyan. Ang nakikita ko, yung charcoal na kahoy, o di kaya yung bako na
yes,
charcoal. Hindi ako nakakita sa palengke. Although, I think in one supermarket, nakapackage yan.
Yes,
eh, hindi ko alam kung marami bang gumagamit niyan. O, at saka, in the first place, kailan marami ang supply niyan? Dahil alam ko, just after harvesting.
Yes, sir.
Yung bang na-process na crickets ay nauubos during that season? For example, halimbawa, maybe sa Nueva Ecija, ano po sa version ninyo na supply and demand at saka utilization yung cricket?
Yes, sir. Actually, yung doon sa yung aming equipment, set of equipment, ay dinala namin sa Pangasinan, Binmali, Pangasinan. So, ang kanila pong mga client ay mga hotel, mga high-end market kasi ito hindi kasi siya kumbaga smokeless. So pwede nilang gamitin na source of heat na ano. Sa atin naman, yun nga, yung sa mga rural, ano eh, siyempre meron pa silang pwede pa, meron pa silang alternative. Ito nga yung mga wood charcoal. Pero kung sa mga high-end market kasi binaban naman na sa atin ang mga charcoal making. So sa ngayon po, yung mga pinupuntahan ng ating mga brigades is sa mga high-end market. And ano po, kulang pa sila ng ano, supply.
Yes. Yes. May nalimutan pa ako. Na-measure niyo ba yung particulate matter emission? Kasi baka source of pollution lang yung ating briquettes. Kasi these are carbonized material, baka puso-pusok lang, no? Although may heat, but it would have a very large particulate matter emission. So this could be a source of pollution. So maybe you could check kung ano yung PM numbers yung briquettes.
Mm. Yes. Actually, ano sir, okay po yung suggestion. Pero in this project, hindi po namin nakuha yung data niyan. Pero yun nga po, through observation, visual observation doon sa aming laboratory. So tinitingnan din kasi namin yung kung may emission ba o ano. So parang ano naman siya, negligible naman siya. But then, maganda nga po kung merong data. Yes. So siguro pag yung sa ano po, yung kung may po kasi sa office is kino-commercialize na namin itong technology. So we are planning to integrate this system doon sa mga biomass bed owner para yun nga po mabawasan yung mga nakasalit na kung dati rice hull po ang nakikita yung nakatambak sa kanina, ngayon ang makikita nyo is mga CRTs. So dito rin po is nag-focus talaga kami sa energy kasi ang ano po ng office, ang mandate ng office is more on energy utilization. So pero pwede naman yung gamitin ng sa mga air conditioner, kaya namin naman po is sinasabi rin naman namin doon sa field rice. Kasi yung kung purely carbonized material, talagang napakalaki po ng potential niya for soil conditioner.
Yes, sir.
Discussion, but my question would be a little bit outside but connected to your research. As a researcher and agricultural engineer, probably may I ask a question that probably you could contribute very much. This is in the field of vermiculture, the production of vermicast produced by the earthworms. In production of the organic fertilizers using the earthworm, we use organic materials to produce the NPK. The nitrogen can be produced from leguminous materials. The potassium can be produced from bananas, banana fruits. But here now is the question, can be assessed from your carbonized materials be used to produce, contribute phosphorus so that we can produce now NPK fertilizer? Thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, Bob. kanilin, sir, yun na ginagamit na po ng pilgays sa kanila, production ng kanilang mga parating guys, parating. Yes, sir, medyo ako, hindi ko ano ang vermiculture. Actually, sa cooperator ko lang nakita na ganito pala ang vermi. Pati nga yung binihal po ni Sir Henry na expert sa organic.
Because, sayang naman.
Yes, sir.
Sayang naman kung we just throw away the assets.
Yes, sir. Pero,
we will not make use of this in producing materials that we can produce in rice culture or other production of materials.
Yes, sir. Actually, yung as po sa amin, hindi namin siya ginagamit as fertilizer, but ginagamit namin siya as nanoparticle to enhance yung mga dinidevelop po namin yung mga polymer o yung mga biodegradable plastic. Kasi napaka-resistant po ng ash. Kaya lang yun yan, ang problema kasi dyan is paano ka maka-generate ng certain amount of ash na i-apply mo doon sa aming mga equipment. Kasi unang-una yung ash po is napakaganda sana gamitin doon sa aming mga parties. Kasi napakataas po ng kanyang heat resistance. Hindi basta-basta masisira yung compared doon sa mga ginagamit namin material. Pero yun nga, sa kumbaga ngayon, kung gagamitin man namin, kung mag-re-research naman kami sa as, focus po kami doon sa ano, as nanoparticle siya to enhance yung aming dinidevelop na biodegradable plastic and then to, yun po, ma-increase yung resistance ng aming mga furnaces. Pero magandang application din sir yung sa fertilization.
Yes, thank you. I see one more hand. Yes.
Hi, sir. I'm Anna Ho from College of Economics and Management.
Ah, yes, okay.
Oh, sorry, tatanong ko lang. Ang concern, main concern is yung sa profitability aspect. Yes. Sir, have you considered taking into consideration the market acceptability of charcoal briquette alone? Kasi, di ba, yung profitability po natin is 1.5 to 3.5 yes. per kilo. Pero kung i-consider po kasi na, parang production-based po kasi
yes,
yung profitability. So kung i-consider natin yung, kung magiging market-based siya, so may percent market share pa siya given na ang competing product niya is wood charcoal. So may possibility na mas kumaba pa yung value of ng profit. So ayun po.
Yes, pamilang suggestion. Pero yun nga, ang assumption namin dito kasi ang wood charcoal briquetting ay alam ko po ay binaban na nila. So parang ang naging assumption ng computation namin dito is talagang wala na, kumbaga lahat na ng mga fuel briquettes natin is biomass based. Although maganda talaga yung ano, yung wood charcoal, kaya lang yun niya, kung meron namang law na pinoprohibit yung pag-charcoal briquetting using yung wood, so wala sila. Pero yun po, maganda yun. May isa.
No more question? Okay, so